In this video, I will show you how to get the quarter number from a date in Excel like this. So let's get started. Here in this Excel sheet, I have some dates in this column. Now I want to calculate the quarter number from these dates in this column. I am going to use the roundup function along with the month function to calculate the quarter number of the year. The roundup function, as the name suggests, rounds the number up to a specified number of decimal places. This function accepts two arguments, the number we want to round up and the number of digits to round up. If the second number of digits argument is 0, the number is rounded up to the nearest integer. For example, this roundup formula will return 2 as the number 1.99 is rounded to 2. While this roundup formula will also return 2 as the roundup function always rounds up the number and the nearest integer of 1.01 is 2. Here is the formula to get the quarter number from the date. Here, the month function returns the month number of the date contained in the cell. The month number is then divided by 3. Since the quarter numbers are always integers, I have specified 0 as the second argument of the roundup function. Let's copy the formula to other cells to get the quarter number for all the dates. Here, the division operation will return a number between 0.33 for the month of January and 4 for the month of December. For example, for this date, the month number will be 1, and when we divide 1 by 3, we get 0.33. The 0.33 value will be rounded up to 1, and that is the quarter number for this date. Similarly, for this date, the month number will be 8, and when we divide 8 by 3, we get 2.66. The 2.66 value will be rounded up to 3, and that is the quarter number for this date. Sometimes we want quarter names like Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4 instead of just the quarter numbers. To do that, we can prepend the capital letter Q with the quarter number formula using the ampersand sign. Let's quickly change the formula for all the dates. As you can see, we now have the quarter names displayed instead of the quarter number for all these dates. We can also replace the letter Q with the full quarter text or any other text you want very easily by changing the formula. For example, here I have prepended the full quarter text followed by a hyphen character instead of the letter Q, so that the quarter names will be displayed like quarter 1, quarter 2, etc. Watch these videos to learn more Excel tips, tricks, and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.